Have I been literally fucking muted this entire time? Cool. Cool, cool, cool. Oh, you missed all of my good jokes. All of my good goofs. About beastmen. And Kyles. Hi. Hi, hello? Hello? Okay, cool. Cool, cool, cool. Anyway, as I was saying, new Beastmen units look real good. In equal disproportion to how much I hate a forced stealth sequence in a Quake Engine third-person shooter. Or first-person shooter. I think troglodons look... I think troglodons are cool. That's...
Must be another power failure. Hold your position. Systems will be back online.
Damn it. Yeah, troglodons seem cool. The new skink units don't seem pretty circumstantial, honestly. And I think, Coattle seem cool, as far as, like, giving the lizards another flying option, and, like, a support flyer, basically, because everything underneath the coattle gets freaking concealment, and so I think there's a lot of fun stuff you can do with that.
Must be another power failure. Hold your position. Systems will be back online.
Oh, I hate this.
Back online.
Yeah, Oxyotl has some real, like, Oxyotl himself seems real good in, like, a I can respect a sniper lord kind of way. No! I blew him up! Like, Oxyotl seems to be like what Marcus Wolfheart was trying to do. But I think, like, in terms of playstyles, the Lizards are still probably my least favorite Game 2 faction. And I think the stuff they put for the Beastmen is way more interesting. So...
systems will be back online.
Oh... kill me... Yeah. Yeah! But I think the additions they got, I think Oxyotl's campaign looks fun. But Tarox's campaign looks way better, looks pretty great. I know, I will probably end up streaming some of that on Wednesday just because of my own sickness. Like, in general, the Beastman updates definitely has my attention. But, yeah, so... did anyone else catch the blindfolded Super Mario 64 run? Where dude did a 70-star run blindfolded. Which is just redunculous? Ah. I got level 3 force pull and push.
That's Luke and Hassan.
Very good cutscenes, very good in-engine cutscenes. Bossed.
What the? We're moving.
Speaking about lizard men, can we all talk about the original lizard man? Dasan? Oh, it's playing the Imperial March. I feel like I was expecting Rakarth to be the last DLC for Total War Warhammer 2, so I'm kind of pleased with, like, this being the closeout, with, like, a Beastman rework and a Dwarf update that makes Dwarfs less painfully boring, even if, what are they doing, not moving Grom Brindle? I bet that takes work. What class of ship is that, ZP?
Kyle, are you there?
Yeah, I thought you said not to fight Dasan alone.
I didn't have a choice. I never even felt him coming. He's escaped onto a ship.
I know. I'm on it.
We need to destroy the ship before Dasan and his army reaches its target, whatever it is. Try to find the ship's communication center and use its sensor array to contact Rogue Squadron. I'll keep trying.
Luke!
Force me to kill.
Yeah. I just think it's nice in the sense that, like, there needs to be more action up in Naggarond. And so having Oxyotl and Torox there maybe means that it won't just be, like, Alithanar being the guy who causes problems for the Dark Elves, and then it all just kind of confederates into one evil blob. Oh, that's fun. You actually disarm them when you do that. And then they run around looking for a weapon. I didn't realize that. Yes. What Imperial class Star Destroyer is this? Is it in that mod for Empire at War? These are the things I need to know. Cut off his arm. Oh, it's a fleet carrier. I see. As much violence as you can get away with in a T-rated game. This once again feels like I am winding up for another boss fight. No, this is definitely the way I have to go. I just gotta find the switch. Just gotta find the switch. Did you record the Dad of Light podcast yet? Are we gonna learn about how familial bonding can be expedited through Final Fantasy 14? Vent I'm missing? Is there some sort of switch? I hate the... Ugnaught. Huh? Oh, I gotta find the communications array, of course. I'll get right on that. Okay. Just gotta find the switch. I'll be honest, if I had not already committed myself to streaming through this game, I probably would have given up like the first or second time I got stuck. Okay, you know what this means. GameFAQs.GameSpot.com. Oh, this guide was written by one Matthew Rory. That's fun. Okay, there's a grate. There's a grate. I wonder if he remembers writing this guide. Okay, yep, I was missing a grate in the ceiling. Of course I was. Ah, yes! Of course! How could I have missed that? There we go. And that's how you'd Star War. Time to get all these portable turrets so I can throw them all down and then realize they don't do anything against certain types of bosses. Oh no. I believe Jeff is still busy. Oh right, now I have strong stance lightsaber. Ah! Rah! You would have to ask him, though. Be free, R5 units. Be free! And thank your liberator, Kyle. Okay, is this one of those things where I have to, like... Okay, I think I know what I have to do. Kind of tired today. I let the dog sleep in my bed, which means that I did not sleep well. To consult. Yes, of course.
Rebel, come. Get out, hey you!
There we go. There we go. Oh, so how's everyone's weekend been? Having a good time? I can't think of anything Star Wars related to bring up into an appropriate context of this conversation, because I feel like I've already worn out every single Star Wars related topic I wish to discuss. This is just the Quake 2 rocket launcher, isn't it? Take this, tiny turrets. I get the distinct impression this is not going to be done today. You're making me crack codes? Disgusting. Disgusting. There was definitely a period when I was playing this where I was pretty gung-ho about, like, yeah, I should totally play I should totally play all of the Jedi Knight games, or all of the Dark Forces games, I guess, technically. And that still might happen, but I think I might need at least a little bit of a break before I get into, like, Jedi Academy, or even, Jedi Knight 2, or Jedi Knight 1. Oh, I regret my life. It's offline. regret my life choices. It does not help that for lunch I got the Papa John thing, the Papadilla, which is literally just a calzone, but it's not folded off. Okay, I need the weird downward arrow thing, which is not any of these. Okay. I see. Blue triangle. Damn, I jump high. Do I have force? Okay, I have force jump level 3 now. That's why I'm just katarning my way up. Okay. If I want Star Wars banter, just think of Kit Fisto. Am I right, my dudes? Who hates Kit Fisto? No one. I'm gonna have someone come in here and be like, actually, Kit Fisto! Next main podcast game is Persona 4. Those lunatics. This is very silly. Is it just gonna be... I'm gonna be disappointed when Geno's just like, ah, it was bad. It's not as good as Final Fantasy IX, the greatest game ever made. Also, that game is... Dude, that game is 80 hours. Minimum. Minimum. 80 hours. Like, we talk about how games are long. A lot, I feel like. But Persona 4 is not a short game. So I think they're looking for us to fill the gaps. I think that's how that goes. Okay, I think I know what to do now. Now where's blue triangle? Take that. You know, this is very inefficient. Has the Imperial Remnant ever considered elevators? That's a bit of humor. A bit of Star Wars humor. I don't know. This trick is called jumping. It's where you bring the character in the air and then you move them. And so they move both vertically and horizontally. Anyway, speaking of Persona 4, it has been a hot minute since I played that. Fun fact, I have never played Persona 4 the entire way through. Like, my experience with that game was predominantly the endurance run. And also, about 8 years ago, I lent my copy of the PS2 version to a friend of mine who went to Japan. After she graduated, and she claims it is still at her grandma's house or something, so maybe one day I'll get my copy of Persona 4 for the PlayStation 2 back, or you know, I can just buy Golden. I could just buy Golden on Steam for $15. Because I still have not seen most of, like, the stuff they added in Persona 4 Golden. Other than, like, the weird epilogue, which... Yeah.
should do it. Come on, Rogues. I hope you're listening.
There we go.
This is Kyle Katarn.
Katarn, good to hear your voice. We've locked onto your signal and are in pursuit. That is one whale down of a ship you hooked, Kyle.
Can you bring her down?
Maybe, but I feel a lot better about our chances if somebody on the inside were working to disable the ship's shield array.
I'll see what I can do about those shields, but I've got some unfinished business here.
Understood. Once you get the shields down, make sure you get out of there in a hurry, because there's not going to be much left of this ship once we're done with her.
Don't waste any time on my account.
Good luck, Kyle. Rogue Leader out.
Got it. And on the way to the shields, too.
How convenient.
All crew members prepare to drop out of hyperspace.
Oh, wow. That is just a big old carrier ship. Yo, where my A-wings at?
Great.
Where are all the B-wings, huh? Where are the B-wings, JJ? These are the questions that keep me up at night. I can't even say that with a straight face. Darth Platformer. Make sure. Oh man, my bitrate is shit right now. No wonder the chat is so behind. I do like by the end of the game, you are just... murder. You are just cutting through hordes of stormtroopers. It's a beautiful sight. And something more video games need to understand the beauty of. There we go. All right. So okay, that's good. Okay, our things are better now? That's good. That's good. Yeah. That's right. It's weird. I feel like the bitrate's doing okay. Hey, I can't control what other people in this household are doing. Action, Kyle. All right, I think I'm gonna call it here, just 'cause just because it seems like things aren't working on my end right now. So, I could reset the internet, but honestly, like, my wrist is starting to hurt in a way. Now the light's green as soon as I threaten to quit. Jesus. Ugh. I do think it's very funny that my bitrate stopped being terrible just as I threatened to stop playing this game. Thanks, Twitch-san. Run in terror, for Kyle has returned. Yeah, no, that's very kind of the stormtroopers to stand in a way that allows me to just murder them. I hate TIE fighters. I believe canonically, by the time of especially the expanded universe post Return of the Jedi timeline, like, the Imperial Remnant was mostly made up of just regular people, if I recall correctly. Okay. But yeah, you know, you made the mistake of mentioning Star Wars lore in the same place as erstwhile co-host Chris Zombie Pie Redacted. Now, as punishment, you get to learn about Star Wars lore. The worst kind of lore. My lore is bad stance still checks out, especially when it comes to Star Wars. No, Disney will not sell you an Ewok fur coat. That does not fit their image of the brand, just like a pink Darth Vader does not fit their image of the brand. Has to be canon appropriate. Which means no Ewok fur coats. George Lucas did not give an absolute fuck about a lot of things by the end of his time with Star Wars the brand, other than a lingering sense of regret. But Disney knows that they have a property, and that if it is not making money in the safest, most unimaginative way possible, they have failed. And so, in that sense, you need to ask yourself, what would Bob Iger do? Yes, and also they are deeply... The other thing, yeah, you need to care about with modern-day Star Wars is the understanding that they are deeply terrified of fan feedback. you are going to get Star Wars Rogue One spin-offs starring Diego Luna, and you're going to like it, motherfucker. You know, everyone's favorite Star Wars character, Cassian Andor. Yes, I remember his name. No, I will not elaborate why. This is why you just need to write fantasy. This is why... See, the problem with writing sci-fi is that there will always be some segment of the audience that, like, cares about actual Newtonian science and, like, physics. Oh, boy. But my point is that, like, if you write fantasy, as long as you give the nerds what they want and give them a plausible enough world building, they're not gonna get bent out of shape. Whereas actual sci-fi fans are going to start yelling at you about actual physics. They're like, oh, actually, TIE Fighters can't make noise in space because space doesn't make noise. And then you throw them out the airlock. I believe is the correct thing to do there. When did Kermit become a Star Wars nerd? When he was bought by Disney. They're both under the same umbrella. Ever think about that? Get behind me, Satan. Are people offended by the sex in your... Sparky, I didn't realize that you were writing, like, erotic thrillers. If you got people offended by sex... I thought you were writing, like, supernatural... mystery books. I mean, there are two ways to write sex scenes, right? You're either George R. R. Martin just like clinically and graphically describing really, really rough stuff. Or you're Brandon Sanderson and you're just, it's just like blushing and hand-holding is like the peak of impurity. Oh, that sounds great. I mean, I know ZP is a serial killer. I don't know about the rapist part.
It's locked. There must be another way in.
Gee, I wonder what that other way might be. Ah, take that ceiling. You will face the wrath of Katarn. Okay.
It's locked. There must be another way in.
I don't see what the problem is here. You know, I believe I shared the story of how I got suspended in middle school for using people's real names in a choose your own adventure story. But you know, that might be a step above, honestly. But the difference is you're not in school, so you can't get suspended for it. Maybe I'll get my dad to read your books. He likes books. I used to read books back in the day. All right, let's go. Heavy stance. Yeah, heavy stance. Well, listen, if you ever need a cannibalistic serial murderer named Braden Arbitrary Water Redacted, the aged, the dubious, Lord of Dubious Murder.
full speed.
Get behind him. Give up.
Yeah. Yeah, well, guess what? Let's a go, motherfucker.
It's locked.
Big fan of using heavy lightsaber stance for the sole purpose of just blasting fools. I bet there's some Jedi who's turned to the dark side because they really like cinnamon rolls. They were tempted by the power of cinnamon roll.
I don't suppose they'll open the doors for me if I just ask nicely.
Darth Car Wash. Oh, you gotta watch out for Darth Car Wash. He and Darth Platformer.
Well, you certainly took your sweet time.
Masters Vevil.
Hey, it's okay. I'm happy to see you too.
I thought you were dead.
Dead? No. In pain? Yes. Dasan and his thugs must have burned out half a dozen interrogation droids trying to get me to crack.
They wanted to know about the Valley of the Jedi, right?
For the first few hours, then they dropped the subject and started asking me about the layout of the Jedi Academy.
The Jedi Academy?
Yeah, Dasan seemed obsessed.
Star Wars.
Oh, no.
Yeah.
What?
I think Dasan's invading the Jedi Academy. We've got to destroy the Doomgiver's shields before he can deploy his troops.
I think I know where it is. Let's go.
It's almost as if the light side, dark side dichotomy is, like, kind of broken and bad. And Star Wars constantly edges towards saying something about it, but can't fully commit because
we're going to have to work together to get out of here. Hold the switch down, Kyle.
You laugh now, but when we do our KOTOR episode, it's gonna be a whole thing.
I'm pretty sure the shield generators are through there.
I know. You get an escape pod ready and wait for me. This shouldn't take long.
Don't do something stupid like die on me.
And put you through the same misery I've been through? Not on your life.
Yay, Kyle. Boo, there's another level. Hey, come over here. Come over here. Hey, I got a present for you. See, the fact that enemies refuse to come into this room, despite my very exciting trip mine, means that trip mines feel useless. Like, I'm sure they're useful in multiplayer, anyway. Off the cliffs with you. Into the Star Wars mines. You will spend the rest of your life attempting to placate an audience that is unplacatable. Truly the most egregious of punishments. There we go. I love to watch them scream in terror. Thank you. Oh, you just gotta love the way the audio loops, but doesn't quite loop enough. And it goes between, like, combat music and non-combat music. Oh man, I'm just zooming now. There we go. Blood for the blood god, skulls for the skull throne. My favorite Kyle Katarn saying. Yes, writhe. Writhe in agony before the power.
of Darth Kyle. Jedi scum. Darth Kyle. Yeah. When people say, who's the most powerful character in Star Wars canonically, they should say it is Kyle.
Get easier.
Yeah. Hiya. Oh shit.
Ah, Captain Katarn. What a pleasure it is to finally meet you face to face.
The pleasure's all yours, I'm sure.
The oarswoman thinks quite highly of you. Did you know that? She must have whimpered your name on at least 17 different occasions over the last few days.
Is that supposed to make me angry? And pass that, Gallic.
Then what if I tell you that even as we speak, Dasan is descending on the Jedi Academy with thousands of his force-enhanced, lightsaber-resistant warriors, eliminating the scourge of the Jedi for all time?
I'd say you're insane.
Insane? Then what about this?
Strike Force 1 to Doomgiver. Eastward assault on Academy grounds proceeding as planned.
Strike Force 2 to Doomgiver. Establishing beachhead outside main entrance.
Strike Force 3 to Doomgiver. Reborn troops advancing on northern perimeter.
Within hours, Dasan will have eradicated those annoying Jedi, clearing the way for my ascent as the leader of the new Empire. I, Galak Fyar the First, the genius who conceived of the Shadow Army, will rule the galaxy with a Cortosis fist. Worlds will tremble. Stars will shudder.
Your shields will fall.
I just want a Mario jump on you. Okay, that does seem to do something. Okay. Thank you. Oh darn. It's all blowing up. Oh, Kyle.
I was just thinking the same thing.
Kyle, you're drifting. Tokyo Drift. Is this a glitch? Because I hope... Oh, shit. There we go. Okay. How disappointing.
Kyle, this is Rogue Leader. We're about to... make a final run, so you better get yourself out of there now.
I was just thinking the same thing.
Oh. Oh. Oh, I see. Video game. I can float up and I can fly. I can fly.
Rogue Squadron's gonna get me killed.
I can fly, I can fly, I can fly. Yeah, I think the idea is that the gravity's off.
Rogue Squadron is doing too good of a job.
Kyle, this is Rogue Leader. We're about to make our final run, so you better get yourself out of here.
I was just thinking the same thing. Rogue Squadron is doing too good of a job.
In the heart.
Move it, Kyle.
Thank you.
hold together a little longer. Stupid remnant ship's falling apart on me. The escape pods are still intact.
Rocket launcher. Yes. This is neat. Anyway. Nope.
Hey, what's up?
Are you streaming?
Yeah.
Oh, I was gonna ask if you want to go to the river with us, but...
I'm streaming right now.
Okay. All right, well, not that way. Okay, now this has stopped being fun, now I'm just irritated. Am I winning, son? I mean, I'm in decent health. I'm doing better than I have been the last couple weeks. But in terms of, am I winning? No. No, I'm not. No, I'm not winning. Okay, it's not that way. So is it this way? Help, my children are dying. No, this has to be the way, because this was the where I started this level from. Ugh. I need an adult. You ever think about how when you need an adult and then you realize that you are the adult. Matthew Rory, here my only hope. Okay. Boom, boom, boom. Shield of Ray. Bup, bup, buh. Okay. Yes, that is this game. This game is from the era of Where the Hell Do I Go video games. There we go. Like, level design in.
Come on, this place is falling apart.
Couldn't happen to a nicer ship either.
Yeah. Alright, here's the question. Do we call it here? Because we're getting to the 2.5 hour mark. Alright, how many Yavin levels are there, actually? 1, 2, 3, 4. Well, the fourth one's just a final fight. Okay, these areas do not seem to...
Join the new Republic troops.
Okay, try to avoid anyone with a lightsaber.
Good advice, Jedi.
Ah, yum, 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 yum. All right, then let's just finish this today.
Go.
That's not how kissing work. And now I have lightning level 3. Actually, you know what? I have a new idea. Gotta channel my inner SGDQ. I have to let the speed run flow through me. Oh, that's fun. Look at how the rain makes the lightsaber. Okay, that's good. That's good shit.
Nice landing.
Sassy. Anyway, just gotta wait for my force to recharge so I can do whatever it is I need to do here. Oh, this is... Yeah, I have to jump up on that thing. I think? Okay, maybe I don't need to go this way. Then why? I have so many questions. Yeah. No, this is where I came from. You know why the Jedi died out? Platforming. Same thing that killed the dinosaurs, really. See, the dinosaurs with their tiny brains and their large, stumpy legs couldn't jump high enough to avoid the spike traps that came when the meteor fell. So just in terms of level design, video game level design, like where am I supposed to go? Where am I signposted? There is none. There is no signposting. And you know, Discovery is not something I necessarily want out of a okay. I looked it up. Yeah. Oh, I hate this. My new strat is just run. Huh?
Yeah, you know, 90s games coming back into fashion, right? That's what I hear. Everyone, now all the people who are nostalgic for games from when I was growing up are old enough to be making games. Which means... we're now at a point where we need bad platformers to come, bad unnecessary platforming to come back. Kids love Pokemon and Final Fantasy VII. So, it only makes sense that we need to bring back unnecessary platforming sequences. I guess Doom Eternal kinda already did that. Heyo. Yeah, that's right. Yeah, does the... yes. I mean, really? I think the genealogy remake for, like, American fans is definitely 2000s nostalgia. Because you have people... because, you know, I think the genealogy translation patch was... that really busted early genealogy patch was, what, 06, 07? That sounds right. Anyway... I'm stoked for a genealogy remake. Assuming it exists, which it probably does. Because, you know, Intelligent Systems finished working on Origami King. So, what else they got? Because Koei Tecmo did most of the heavy lifting on Three Houses. That's like... That's why that game looks like ass. Yeah. And, you know, Way Forward is working on the Advance Wars. So, yeah, that makes sense in the sense that they actually put work into Fire Emblem Three Houses setting, as opposed to, like, the continent where Fates takes place is never actually named. Like, that's how little of a shit they gave about that game. I just do not care for this. Be careful. If you say that too loud, Nintendo might listen to you. Yeah, because the way Three Houses ends is so... varies fairly significantly depending on which campaign you end up playing. Like, needs be said. Oh, cool. That's backward. For as much as it, like, killed my soul inside to play those opening chapters multiple times, or all right, so here's what you do. You do the same thing that Elder Scrolls did for their canon following Daggerfall, which was a time warp happened. Like, reality itself got disrupted. And so all the endings are canon. It's like Deus Ex. Now, never mind that one ending of Three Houses, like... yep, that's how they solved Daggerfall. You know, for all that deep Elder Scrolls lore I've been told the kids are into. Sure does. The ancient future people who are behind everything. You ever think about how at one point in that game dubstep happens? I think so. That sounds right. Three Houses is pretty good. Did I ever beat? No, I never beat Golden Deer. The only campaign I ever beat was Edelgard, Crimson Flower, which feels like it deserved way more, considering how different it is from every other campaign. And then I'm to understand that Silver Snow is like almost the exact same as the Golden Deer campaign, except the last map is different and like some of the plot is a little different, because you know, you're the Black Eagles. But anyway, siding with the Church of Seiros makes you a cop. And I, self-progressed Fire Emblem nutcase, did not have the sense of concentration necessary to want to play through every single campaign in those games. Because they're very similar to one another. And it really doesn't help that the first part of the game is completely the same. Like, and the second half, wears out its welcome because it still makes you do the monastery stuff. Yeah. Anyway. But I think a genealogy remake could be real good if they handled it well. Of course, that being a big if. But I feel like a lot of Three Houses feels like a test run. At least in terms of like the tone they were going for. Yes, yes, yes. Your objections have been noted. Guy who says, they shouldn't put waifu bullshit in this game, in the remake of a game that started the waifu bullshit. We can talk about how overpowered, like, how much genealogy relies on overpowered units to just mop up. Just mopping up. And then you have your regular units and they just kind of get a kill or two here and there because their value is non-existent. Because you can just solo almost all of part one as Sigurd. And you can do a lot with just Salif in part two. With whoever gets the Forseti tome. Assuming, you know, paired Leywin with someone good. Huh? I always heard you should have Arthur get Forseti because he comes way earlier and has a horse, which means he can actually move. That's what I was always to understand. Sorry. Yep. Like, there are definitely a couple ways, like, I bet part two of genealogy is way harder. With the replacement units, but also I did all the guides. Okay, nope, that's backwards. Nope. They will never make another game in that style, except for a remake. Well, isn't the whole thing that the guy in charge of the Shining games, like, hates the old Shining Force games at Sega? And so that's why, like, the series doesn't get a ton of representation, necessarily? I thought that was the reason. And which is why, like, Shining Resonance Refrains sure exists. I'll take your word for it. I don't really... I am not opposed to playing a Shining Force game. As someone who is not a Genesis kid, I just look at Shining Force, like the, you know, the first three Shining Force games, and I say, oh, it's Sega's answer to Fire Emblem. Hey, can I drive this? No. Yeah! Oh, this sucks.
Yeah. Yeah, that's the thing, is that, yeah, Shining Force... Shining Force made it here, and Fire Emblem did not in the 90s. So that's the... That's where... It gets weird. In case you were wondering, this AT-ST does not feel good to control. Which, hey, I guess... A dark Jedi! There we go. Well, the other fun thing about Shining Force 3 is that it was a three-part series where the US only got part one. So I know there's some fun stuff with that, where two-thirds of Shining Force 3 never came out in the United States, because if you were a Saturn owner, if you were a U.S. Saturn owner, you lived a sad life. Okay, okay. You know what? We're gonna call it here. Because we've reached the 3-hour mark. And we'll just see the end of this game maybe tomorrow. We'll see. Also, my arm's starting to hurt. Which is my cue to not play a video game where I wiggle a mouse around quickly. But yes, tactics games have made a comeback. Who could forget such excellent tactics games as X-Cops? But we'll have to talk about that another time, because I'm gonna lie down for a bit. But thanks everyone for watching. I hope y'all had a good weekend, and remember that bunny hopping is the way of a true Jedi, and also the Beastman rework looks really good.